And I'd like to move on to our last speaker in this presentation now, who is Miguel Angel Higuera. And Miguel is a DVM from the University Complutense in Madrid, where he has specialized in swine livestock. And he has worked in industry and in the veterinary medical faculty on various aspects of pork production. I won't go through them all in detail, but he has a long history of working in relation to pork, the pork industry. He's also involved at Copa Codjeca in three groups: the swine meat, the environment, and animal health and welfare. He's also involved with the European Federation for Animal Health and Health Safety and the European Livestock and Meat Trade Union. So Miguel is going to talk on good practices of industry driving production. So over to you, Miguel. We're looking forward to your presentation.
Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here. So thank you for the invitation. Let's go. I would like to bring you an example of good practice of industry driving the production. The example that we and also some of you can note is the Iberico. The Iberico and the Dehesa. How can we work together with the animals and also with an special countryside that is the Dehesa. I have some problems with the. I don't know if the video is going to work. So we have an environment, a special environment that is the Dehesa, where there are the trees, and also how we can combine, and also how we can also work with the Iberico animals. So, and this is very, very good. So the Dehesa area is between Spain and Portugal, is in the Iberico Peninsula. We have more than 3 million of hectares of this kind of forest that we have between both countries. I have a video, but yes, maybe it's going to work. I hope you can see, because this is a video take for the Google Maps. So you go to the Google Maps for this area where the Dehesa are in Spain, you can find very easily what is this kind of countryside. For example, here in the middle between the Extremadura and Andalusia region, with making the zoom in the Google Maps, you can find directly where the Dehesa are in any point of this area of Spain. You can see what is the trees, and also what is the locations, and also you can move for the Google Maps, and maybe also you can find what is, of course, the trees, what is the different farms located, that you can have a small farms for the Iberico pigs and also for sheep and for cows. But you can see in every place what is this fantastic forest system. And we in Spain, not only in Portugal, there are another 1.5 million of hectares, but only in Spain there are 3 million of hectares of this kind of forest in related, and also direct vinculated. There are more farms here, for example. This is something that you can do in the Google Maps to see what is the Dehesa located in Spain and Portugal. So what is the most important of the Dehesa? The Dehesa is a human-made ecosystem. So that is distributed through the province of Salamanca, Cáceres, Badajoz, Huelva, Seville, Córdoba, and Ciudad Real. This is in Spain. So this is very located in the southwest of the Spain. So it's a Mediterranean forest with acid solid and scattered trees, especially with whole oaks and core oaks with scumbag and soaked rock saws and broom. The most important is that only this special ecosystem is up to the wildlife. So there are deers, there are wild boars, there are wood pigeons. So there are a lot of wild species that is living together. And this is a very important issue for the healthy aspect, because they are living together with the one native domesticated animal, that is the Iberian pigs, the most important. But there are another breed of bovine, that is, for example, the Retinta cow, and also the Merino sheep, that is also together, living all together in this kind of the ESAP. Of course, there are differences, areas and special areas for the domestic animals. So this is not possible to put together the Iberian and the cows. So there are special farms only dedicated with Iberico pigs and another that they are dedicated for bovine productions. But at the end, this kind of ecosystem can be used for all these kind of animals. What is the most important things of the DESA when we are talking about the ecosystem? That there are some produce that we can obtain of the DESA. One, of course, is the production for the oaks, that is ruining the Iberico pigs because they are going to eat the acorns. Also because we can produce wood and also for the cork. So there are these three production directly for the trees. Of course, between the trees, that there are must to be a distance between the trees to be sure that there is not overproduction of the trees, can be pasture. There are pasture land for the extensive livestock farming, mainly linked with the sheep and bovine products. And also there are some areas that is possible to have the cereals, and also these cereals can be used for animal feed. So this is all the production that we can obtain for this area. And this is the pictures that you can see in the left side, that is clear that is a forest that has been human made. In the most important of that we have to keep it. So it's not only important in the DESA to raise the animals, to make a very, very good selection, genetic selection, examine of the animals. Also, we have to make the same with the trees. So there are a selection of the trees. There are how many number of trees you have to plow every day, every years. What is the number of the animals that the trees that have to remove? So there are a very huge work keeping this DESA. So it's not a natural forest. It's of course natural, but it's a human-made one. And in the other hand, we have the animals, the pigs. The Iberico pigs, the name of the Iberico pigs is a generic name because there are different breeds of Iberico. This is some pictures of some differences between the Iberico that are, for example, the Lampiño, Negro Entrepelado, Retinto, Rubio Andaluz, Manchado de Jabugo. There are some different breeds that are under the umbrella of the Iberico name. So there are differences that are using depending of the area in Spain that prefer one kind of animals, and also a crossbred between difference of these animals. So at the end, there are a lot of different animals, and also together with the beef and the sheep production. What is the thing that is more important? That all the Iberico production in the DESA and also in the farms are absolutely under control. There are a royal decree in Spain that is for 2014 that is for the quality standard rules for the Iberian meat, ham, shoulder, and loin. And it has to be mandatory if they want to put the name of Iberico in these high quality products. This made it, of course, this quality standard to standardize the process of production of this kind of animals, and also to avoid any misunderstanding with the consumers. To know when you are going to buy a product for the Iberico, you know exactly what you are buying, and also you have to pay the value of these animals. So this is the difference between the intensive and extensive production in Spain. So when we are talking about the intensive production is when we have more of 15 pigs per hectare. And we are talking about the extensive productions when you have less than 15 pigs per hectare. So this is very important because in another country, or maybe most of you are used to call outdoor production that is in an open air. Remind that in Spain, when we are talking about the extensive, it has to be less than 15 pigs for every 10,000 square meter. Less than 15 pigs. This is real, real and extensive production. And with this density of the animals, we can be sure that there are a very good balance between the animals and between the environments to be sure that we have not an overproduction and an over capacity of the production. For the quality standard, we have at the end four different labels, four different colors. That is the white one that is in the bottom of the slide. That is the Iberico cebo that is raised in a traditional farms. Then is the green one, that is the cebo de campo, that is also raised in a traditional farms, but with more space. They need 100 square meters per animals. And there are the two other colors, that is the red one and the black one, that is the animal that has been produced in the dehesa in a period of time called Montanera, and has been fed with acorns in these 2-3 months that has to be produced these animals. Of course, the production of this kind of animals feeding with acorns is limited because they have a limited in the time. So the acorns is only produced in the winter time, and also is limiting because the dehesa, we have only a definite number of hectares for the hectare, and it's not possible to produce in every place. So when we are talking to define what is the requirements to be sure that we have a perfect balance between the forest, the dehesa, and the animals, are these requirements to produce the animals. So the Iberico, the bellota, that is feeding with acorn, that can be also 100% of Iberico, and also with a crossbred with a Duroc. Always the female has to be the Iberico, and they have the possibility that the sire can be the Duroc animals. So these products come from animals slaughtering immediately active of the exclusive use of acorns, grass, and another natural resources of the dehesa. So it's mandatory not to include nothing of feed for these animals. Have to be full, 100% natural feed for the dehesa. Of course, this is a seasonal production, so the animals can be go directly to the dehesa between the October 1st to the December 15th. So this is the time that the animals can go inside. This is the entries. And then the period of the slaughter of these animals start in the 15th of December and finalize the 31st of March. The minimum time that these animals has to have on the dehesa is 60 days, and they need to increase at 46 kilos from the entrance to the slaughterhouse. So, and also the minimum age to go to the slaughterhouse in this animal has to be 14 months. And the objective of the carcass weight is 115 kilos for the crossbred animals. And it is a pure animal with 100% Iberico. The carcass weight can be 110 kilos. Most important, all this process has to be made it with a certification body, a third party that has to come to the dehesa and also check every month what is the number of the animals and also what is the density of the animals and what is the quantity of the production of the trees to know exactly if there are enough acorns to feed the animals and to be sure that you are going to have these 46 kilos in the dehesa. Of course, the official controls are maybe for the competent authority of the local or the local region in Spain. But this is the most important, I think, that is the density of the animals in the dehesa. Why? Because at the end we need to be sure that we have a very good balance between the animals and the sources. So depending on the number of the trees that are available in the dehesa, you have the possibility of introduce different numbers of the animals. There are also by law, but I make also the translation to English. So depending on the number of the covered area with the trees, also is analyzed for the SICBAC, that is a tool maybe for the CIP in Spain, also for the recorder of the CIP in Spain. But depending of the quantity of the percentage of the cover area, you can include a maximum stocking density. So if you have only, for example, a 10% of trees in your area, the density of the animals is 0.25 animal per hectare. What is the average? The average is between 40-45% of the wood area in the dehesa. So the average of the Iberico production is 1 pigs per hectare. So this is real, the IOTA productions. When I talk to you, what is the legislation in Spain that for be sure that its extensive production is less than 15 animals, this 15 animals has to be feeding with feed, compound feed, but if you won't produce only vertical production with the IOTA, that 100% has feeding with the natural sources, the average of the production is 1 animal per hectare, 1 animal for 10,000 square meters. So this is, I think, a very huge important. And last but not least, one of the most important things of the dehesa has to have not only sustainability for the environment, that is absolutely clear, because the balance between the animals and also the production is clear, but also is the economic. In a conventional farm, for example, for 1,000 animals with 2.4 cycles per year of these fattening units, and in Spain that we are working with integration model, you can have between 12 and 14 euros per animal, so you can have an income between 26,000, 33,000 euros per year for these 100 animals of farm. If you move these 100 animals for a dehesa, you have 100 hectares with only one circle per year, because you need these 3 months that the animal has to be eating the acorns, and the other part of the year you can also have your bovine production or sheep, but not pigs. And the payment for the rice, these animals, for the owners of the dehesa is between 110-114 euros per animal. So the total income for this 100 hectare only for the production of the Iberico pigs is between 110,000, 140,000 of euros. So this is very important, because at the end, we would like to keep some idyllic productions with the dehesa, with the trees, and also with the perfect balance between the animals and the environments. It's clear that the economical sustainability is the key factor. If there are not any economical sustainability of that, it's not any possible to do that. And at the end, of course, not only for the production, also because this kind of animals and this kind of the production that is a little bit expensive than the others, have to be used for the final destination, that is the consumption. If we are not going to consume this kind of products, there are not any possible of economic sustainability, social sustainability, and environmental sustainability. At final, the final is that we have to eat the products, and this is the kind of typical products of about the Iberico hams, and also the fresh meat. This is the photo in the bottom, that also is for my kitchen, that this is the color of the meat coming from Iberico raised from with bellota, that is absolutely different than the others. So we really believe that this kind of productions between and a perfect union between the animals and the environment is a very good example. Unfortunately, it's quite impossible to share with another region in Spain and also with another region in the world, but when we can have the possibility to live together the animals and the environments, and we can do, and also try to produce a different product and more sustainability, and also more link with the rural areas and with the rural development. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much, Miguel. That was really interesting, and you've also made us hungry looking at those very nice foods at the very end.